It's time for a boss. I hope. Oh yeah. I'm on Act 2, not Act 3. See, I told you I have a bad long-term memory, short-term memory. Pretty much anything you could put before the word memory, I have a bad one. I have bad muscle memory. There's that one-up block I was talking about. I think I touched it the first time I was here, and it didn't actually give me a one-up, so I'm not going to try again. Although I'm probably just going to hit the gold again anyway. I'd like to get at least one emerald, just to prove that I can. Because honestly, this is kind of embarrassing. Okay, that's a goal. There's the emerald. It's surrounded by gold blocks. Or it's sitting on top of gold blocks. That doesn't strike me as a very good idea. I mean, it would just take, you know, a slight inaccurate movement to hit the goal instead of the emerald, like I'm about to do. I'm gonna wait for it to rotate again. I could hit the rotation block, but fuck that. Yeah, that's my rationale. Fuck that. Alright. What?! I knew that was gonna be a bad idea. I keep hitting start there to skip, but start pauses, even on that screen. Alright. Starry Night Zone Act 3. Let's hope I don't get stuck in any walls this time. Knock on wood! Throw some salt over my shoulder. Stepped on a crack. Wouldn't break my mother's back. I don't believe in that shit. I don't believe in anything that doesn't believe in me. Alright, that was gay. I apologize. I don't know what I'm doing quoting that, of all things. But I sound like one of those douchebag atheists who, like, goes around pushing his beliefs on everyone. I don't care what people believe. I'll respect your beliefs if you respect mine. And I believe that the entire universe was sneezed into existence by a being called the Great Green Arcle Seizure. That's my religion. And you should respect it. Let me teach it in schools. Teach the controversy, that's what I say. I mean, some people... Okay, that doesn't protect you from those projectiles. I mean, some people might believe in God. You know, some people might believe in the Big Bang. I believe in the Great Green Arcle Seizure. And my beliefs are just as valid. Maybe I should be the next L. Ron Hubbard. And, you know, start a religion. And make millions by brainwashing people into giving me their money. And if I offend any Scientologists on my subscriber list, then I don't apologize because I don't want Scientologists watching my videos. If you're a Scientologist, banned from my channel. Everyone else, religion-wise, is cool though. As long as, you know, you respect the Arcle Seizure. 50 points to anybody who says what that's from, by the way. Okay, I need to be careful here because I keep dying. See, I thought I was invincible because it was playing the music, but I wasn't invincible, I just had the speed shoes. That's very confusing to somebody in an inebriated state like myself. I mean, I listen for these cues so I know when I do and do not have to be careful. Alright, this is where I have to be careful, because there are bottomless pits all over the place around here. There's one under me right now. Alright, I think I'm safe to roll, not safe to jump. Ugh. See, this was what was wrong with Sonic Rush. Too many bottomless pits. I mean, I like Sonic Rush, don't get me wrong. But, I mean, you have to admit that the bottomless pits got kind of annoying after a while. Especially since the whole point of the game is to be fast and, you know, not be particularly careful. But I mean, overall, the level design for this hack is great. So far, my only objections are getting stuck in the walls. That was kind of lame, but I mean, it's not like they did that on purpose. but presumably they designed these bottomless pits on purpose. And for that, I am slightly disappointed. Alright, time to be really lame and slow and not dash or run or anything fun. Okay, let's try going this way. There's all kinds of stuff over here. I just need to not get fan-fucked. Ugh! Why did I do that again? Why do I keep doing that? I think maybe it's about time to call it quits. No, I can't, because I don't have a save state for the last time. I'm gonna have to at least play this for, you know, 11 minutes so I have a video. Hopefully, eventually, I land on that swinging platform. But, you know, don't press your luck or anything. No whammies, no whammies, stop. Did I just pass it? I saw a swinging platform. Was it the same one? See, now I'm all confused. This is a different part. By the way, this game still isn't hard. I'm just messing up in stupid ways because I've been playing for like, you know, half an hour and, you know, starting to, you know, lose my intoxication a little bit. I don't like using words like buzz, and really I don't like the word drunk. I like, you know, because I don't really get drunk in the normal sense of the word, the way most people would consider themselves to get drunk. I just, okay, that's a different platform. Glad to clear that up. But, I don't know what the best way to go would be. Let's see. Let's go this way. That looks pretty safe. This is a long level for a boss level. Or maybe it just feels long because I've had to start over like 6 times. Oh god! Don't tell me I'm gonna have to do this over a bottomless pit. Oh, Jeebus. Jeebus H. Crispies. Wow, I can almost hit him from like right here. I mean, I probably could if it would let me do a homing attack on him, but I doubt it will. And I probably shouldn't try because if I do, I'm just gonna hurl myself into the bottomless pit. So, yeah, let's do this the careful way. Oh hey, he gave me like 4 rings. That's nice of it. It is nice of it to put a lamppost right there though. Alright, time to strategize. Basically what you have to remember about this boss is that if the spiky balls are allowed to explode naturally, then they're going to shoot little projectiles everywhere. But if you flip them up in the air like so, then there are no projectiles. So you're always safer near a ball that you flip up in the air than you are one that you don't. If what I just said makes any sense at all. I can't even tell at this point. Oh, only died once to the sky. That wasn't too bad. Man, the last time I played Sonic 1, it took me like 4 or 5 tries just to kill that boss. I don't know why. I don't know what I was doing wrong. Oh man. I could do something really dumb here. I'm not going to. Whoa. There was a Robotnik in that container. Alright. Well, coming up pretty close to the end here. Let's just take a quick look at the next level. It is called the Metallic Base Zone. Now see, this is kind of a shame because the Scrap Brain Zone in Sonic 1 has one of my favorite video game tracks ever. I mean, Scrap Brain Zone music is pretty much, you know, the be-all end-all music on the Genesis. Except for maybe the Collision Chaos Zone from Sonic CD. Past. Because that has some excellent music. Alright, I think I'm about to call it quits for the night. I have some good material saved up, so I will see you next time on Let's Play Sonic Megamix. I'm the Dukester, your YouTube, and I will see you later.